I'm going to describe how we would determine activation energies for a chemical reaction if we have data for rate constants as a function of temperature. And the best way is to use nonlinear regression. And so the idea, of course, is we're interested in determining a pre-exponential factor and an activation energy where T is absolute temperature, E is the activation energy, R is the gas constant. And the way we're going to do this is to rewrite this as K0 times an exponential minus E over R, but now 1 over T minus 1 over T0. So this K0 really corresponds to the rate constant evaluated at temperature T0. This makes for a more stable numerical technique to find the best fit values. It also gives us the advantage that we have a pretty good idea of the value we should guess for K0, because we're going to pick the temperature T0 as halfway in between, so 770 K, and which means our guess for K0 is going to be 0.2, and that should put us pretty close to the actual value and make the solution better. Now, the approach, of course, is what we want to do is minimize this summation of our calculated value, K calculated from, put this up here, from this equation, minus the experimental value. That's the value over here. And we're going to minimize that sum of squares. I won't talk here about the details of how we do that. Other screencasts will show using polymath or using Excel to do that, but let's look at the results of carrying out this approach to determine the two parameters, K0 and E. So I'm showing here the output from polymath. I show the initial guesses for the parameters here, and then the nonlinear regression to the values. Also the 95% confidence limits, which gives us an idea of how good a fit we have. And these confidence limits certainly are a small fraction of the value. The R squared value is very high. Well, the run number gives us indication of the residuals, namely the difference. So the residual here is the difference between our calculated value. Let's go back up here. This is a residual. And we took the squared residuals and then summed them to get the minimized least squares solution. And so run number is how many changes of sign there are in the residuals. In other words, two positives, that's one run, two negatives, a second run, a positive is a third run, and negative is a fourth run. So run number is 4. What we expect the run number to be is the number of data points over 2 plus 1. And so we have 6 data points over 2 plus 1. So 4 is what we expect the run number to be. And if we look at the plot of residuals, there does not seem to be any pattern. So this seemed like a good fit for the activation energy in K0. We can then calculate A, which I show here. And we calculate A just by going back to our definition. And we see A is going to be K0 E exponent to R over T0. Okay, so explain more about the confidence intervals, way we can calculate them in other programs. But you can see nonlinear regression is a good approach to obtain activation energy, particularly if we use this form for the equation that we're going to model.